Hi guys, so today I'm going to be making a video on bitless bridles that I think work really good for if you're training your horse for bitless dressage. Some of them I recommend, some of them I don't. So I'm going to start with the oldest one I have, which is this one right here. It is a European hack Amour. When I bought it, they were calling them English jumping hack Amours, but it's just a regular English hack Amour. So it has a leather in the front, which you can make to size, and then it has like a wool backing. And then it has this curb chain on the bottom. Now, this one, I bought this one a long time ago. It's over 10 years old. The newer ones, I believe that the felt that they put on the bottom is man-made. It's not real fur. This one is still original real wool. So this one goes off leverage. Okay, so when you pull on the reins here, it puts more pressure through the nose. This one you want to put where the jawbone is. You want to put it 3 fingers down from that jawbone, so it sits right on the top of the muzzle. You don't want it too low. Now this one works fairly good in getting the horse to work through its vertical. It does not help lift the horse up. Basically, the horse will not tuck its hocks under and lift itself up with this one. I would only recommend this for a horse that already knows how to carry itself naturally. Not for a green horse, just because, like I said, you don't have that leverage to help them lift up in the shoulder and, you know, work off their hocks and stuff like that. This one will probably cause a young horse to fall on his forehand more than anything and give you a false vertical. Basically, the horse's head looks like it's in a vertical, but his body is not. His body is strung out and hollow, so it'll give you a false vertical if your horse does not know how to carry itself. So this one I don't really recommend as far as, you know, teaching a horse for a bitless bridle as far as dressage goes. Now, if you're only doing jumping, this one would work fine just because a horse will naturally lift its head up to look at a jump. You might not have a lot of breaks with this just because a horse will run through this if they're pretty strong. So this is an older one. I don't recommend it for bitless dressage just because it has a couple of faults. But, you know, I have it because I tried it and that was my experience from it. Like I said, I wouldn't use it for a green horse. I would definitely use it for a horse that's already been trained under bit and you want to start going bitless. Something that already knows how to carry itself naturally. Okay, as far as bridles go, I will go with the oldest one that I have, which is the Dr. Cook's Bitless Bridle. Most of you guys should know the Dr. Cook's. It's a cross under. Basically, let me move all these straps out of the way. It crosses under the horse's head. Jeez. And then, depending on which rein you pull, it pushes... The horse's head. So if you pull on this rein here, it engages on, if you pull on the right rein, it engages on the left side and it pulls the horse's head over. Okay, and the same with the opposite. The cross under is really mild. It's really nice. For a green horse, this will definitely teach him how to go bitless. You cannot pull on both reins for the horse to stop. It will not give you that action. Actually, you will be fighting a tug of war with the horse if you pull on both reins, just because the horse can use the leverage against you. It works off of their nose here. It does not work off of the chin or the pole. It's basically all nose action. So you want to have a horse that's soft on the nose. The only thing with the Dr. Cook's that I don't like is, again, you don't have the lift to get the horse to lift up in the front and move under with its hocks. This is a really nice bridle to also to start in if you did your groundwork and your horse is flexing and bending under saddle and you don't want to put a bit in their mouth. You can start them with a Dr. Cook's. That's fine. You're just going to take a little bit longer to get the horse to engage itself. And it will also give you a false vertical if your horse does not know how to carry itself. Just because if you pull on both reins and you're using the nose action, the horse is going to back away from that pressure to go into a false vertical to get away from that pressure. You just have to know how to sit yourself in order to push the horse and drive the horse underneath itself. This one, I see a lot of people using it for bitless dressage. It's not a bad bridle. Like I said, it gives you a pull-push thing. And the only thing with the Dr. Cooks is that, you know, you're pulling on opposite reins. So you're working on the opposite side of the horse, which kind of gets kind of conflicting after a while. But it's a nice bridle. I have used this one. It works really well on a horse that's not 100% green, but a horse that has some knowledge of, you know, walk, trot, and canter, and something that you can slowly train into working on the vertical. But in the beginning, just be aware you will have that false vertical because of the nose pressure. So you really have to drive your seat under to get the horse to work through itself. The next one is the Rambo Micklem bridle. I have it set up for bitless. Okay, so I haven't used it in bitless for a long time. But most of them come with this bitless attachment here. So it goes through the chin strap here. And then when you have reins attached to it, these are... It's kind of hard to do. These right here are down. Okay, so you're pulling left for left and right for right. And it's still going to, you know, push on the opposite head, but you have... What you have here with the Micklem is you have a nose, chin, and also pull pressure at the same time. Now, the way that works is because of how the bridle is itself set up, okay? So the bridle has this arch, so it's not pushing on any major pressure points. But this is going to go right underneath that jawbone, and then it's going to go down, and it's going to hit right probably about on the edge of the nose. You're still going to have about 3 fingers from the nose tip to where this is hitting. So that when you do pull on these reins, this actually engages for the nose, and then you have this underneath the chin, which also gives it kind of like that pull effect. So the horse is going to drop its head, and it's also going to pull a little bit on the pole. Now the pole itself, as you can see, the Micklem is really thick. It's to keep the pressure away from the ears. This one works really well for any horse to learn how to go bitless. Now, they do have an add-on attachment that you can put, which gives it a cross-under effect, kind of like the Dr. Cook's. I don't recommend that just because, again, you'll be in the same situation as the Dr. Cook's bridle, where you're pushing and pulling. You want something like this where it's set up where you're pulling on this rein here, and the horse can kind of feel it, so they're going to give to that pressure a little bit better. As far as getting the horse on the vertical, it does help get the horse on the vertical, but again, you have to engage your seat in pushing and driving that horse from the back end to the front in order for him to drop into that vertical. As far as lifting the individual shoulders that you want when you do like any kind of vertical work and stuff like that, if your horse is really sensitive, it will help lift up the same shoulder that you're pulling on just because of the different chin action. Some horses might not understand that and might have a little bit of trouble doing that. So that's where rider aids come in effect. You need to be able to use your legs in order to lift that individual shoulder up, leg on, you know, inside leg to outside leg and all that lovely jazz. That one I do recommend for a beginner horse, all the way up to advanced. Now, of course, the longer you work on your horse with a bit before you go on bitless, if you've been riding it a bit for a long time, if your horse knows how to engage itself with a bit and you move on to bitless, that one would be absolutely perfect to transition into. Now, the bridle itself, the Micklem bridles are on the pricey side, but you pay for what you get. The leather is awesome. I think for this one, it has a lunging canvas and hook on it. I think I paid $195 for it. This is absolutely my favorite bridle out of all the bridles that I have, just because it's so well made and it fits most of my horses. It doesn't fit Fancy because she has a fat head, but this is my go-to bridle of all of my horses, if the bits fit. I mean, there's some bits that don't fit to it just because of the long shanks and stuff like that. Now my other bridle, which I have on Fancy, so it has the reins attached, is this one right here. This is from Royal Saddlery. Now this one has kind of a different style look. As you can tell, the noseband has the attachment above the nose, and then it has the reins here. Now this one is not a cross under. This is the same action as pull left, you go left, and right, and for left, right. This one I just started riding, and now I did notice that it does have a nose action. It has a little bit of a chin and some pull action on it itself. It's really well made. Now this one I have noticed that if I don't drive fancy with my seat, she does kind of fall on the forehand. It does have a little bit of lift when you pull on this, just from the way it's made. So you can kind of lift the horse up. It lifts them up through almost the side of the chin effect. So when you're lifting, it lifts up the shoulder on that side. This bridle, because Fancy is green, I can recommend this bridle for a green horse. Maybe one that has just been started, as fluent in walk and trot and a little bit of canter. It has a great stop to it. Of course, with any bitless bridle, you want to ensure that your horse knows hoe and that you can hoe the horse on it. So this one I really do enjoy. Now, my ultimate grail bridle I bought last year is the Orbitless bridle. Okay, this one has a really soft wool attachment to it. You can take the wool out and buy a regular leather attachment for a little bit more pressure on the nose. I like anything soft on my horse's nose because I don't want to damage any nerves. This one will work off of the nose, the chin, and the pole at the same time, depending on where you attach the reins here and where you attach the cheek pieces here. Right here, okay? This one I started Fancy off of. This one will give you ultimate lift. It will teach the horse how to rock back on its hocks. It will also teach the horse how to lift individual shoulders because it lifts on that side of the horse. This one is my ultimate go-to. Now, I don't have it on Fancy right now. It's just because I need her to work a little bit more off of her front end and push underneath herself. So I'm trying to teach her to be a little bit more soft and supple. And that is exactly why I'm using this one, because it's teaching her how to be a little bit more soft. This one I will go back to probably midsummer just to get her to really round out and work properly off of herself. The Orbitless bridle is from the UK. I think I paid somewhere around $100 plus shipping and handling for it to come in. It came in within a week, so it wasn't too bad. This one I do highly recommend. If you're going to do bitless dressage and you want to compete in bitless dressage and it's legal, you know, once bitless dressage becomes legal and they allow you to go on the Orbitless one, this is the one you would want to show in. Just because you have the same effect as if you would have a regular bit in the horse's mouth. It's mild, it's not harsh, and it sits right on the main bone of the horse. So when you're measuring for this one, you're going to put your finger right where the soft spot is of the nose. Four fingers up from that soft spot on that hard surface, that's where this one goes. Because it's going to pull that horse up when you pick up the rein. This one, you really have to make sure that your horse is soft and supple and they know how to flex and bend when you pull on that rein. Because if you're pulling and the horse does not know how to give to that pressure, you're not going to be able to achieve anything under saddle. So with any bitless bridle, you want to make 100% sure that you're flexing and bending and the horse is listening to you when you ask them to bend and flex. One rein stops are going to be your best friend in any bitless bridle because you don't have a bit. You can't pull on both reins. And even with a bit, you want to teach your horse how to stop with a one rein stop, okay? As far as my recommendations go, as far as what to really ride in when you're doing bitless dressage, this is my number one. My Micklin is my number two. Fancy's bridle is my number three. And then last is my Dr. Cook's cross under. It's the very last one I would recommend riding in as far as training goes. So if you guys have any questions or concerns, go ahead and leave the questions down below and I'll get back to you guys as soon as possible. And I will put a link to all these bridles down in the description box. So as always, guys, helmets on, heels down, and be safe out there. And I'll see you guys with the next video tomorrow for the vlog. Bye!